We are looking at CBSE AISSCE 16-17 paper for computer science. This is section B, only for candidates who have opted for Python. So the questions are based on Python. Which of the following can be used as valid variable identifier in Python? Total can be used, 7, the variable cannot start with a numeral. This is not allowed and this is a keyword. So the correct answer is total. Name the Python library modules which need to be imported to invoke the following functions: seal and randed. Wherever rand comes, you have to import the random, and for sealing you need to have math and random. Rewrite the following code in Python after removing all the syntax error. Underline each correction done in the code. So this is a double quote, so you have to give double quotes like this, and this is empty, so just give empty, and here there should be round bracket. So these are certain error, and this also t comma text, you want to show the t and text. So first is this, double quotes, and this is a round bracket, and this square bracket, and this t comma text. And one more thing is there, because this is 0 to 7 and grade is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it will give you a out of range error, because the range should be 0 to 5. It goes up to 0 to 4. That is why. Find and write the output of the following Python code. So what is happening here is 90, 10, 30 and 40. So the count is 3. So if the count starts here, and the values are taken from here, means first this float s, this is converted into float. This is float s, means you are taking this str count, that is the third one. First you are taking the third one, and then you are adding this I, this one here, and converting the content into float. So what is happening here is, let me show you. First of all, because it is 3, this is 3, first of all count is 3. So the 3 is, this is 0, index I am showing 1, 2, 3, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. So 40 will come here. This will be float as, that is 40.0 it will become. And I, that is 1 is added. First of all, this I, 1 will be taken. 40.0 plus 1, that is 41. Then next is, the count will be decremented. So count will become 2. So str2 will be nothing but this 10. So 10 will be taken. And now when 10 will be taken, this I 2, because now this has gone to 2, so 10 will be added with 2, this 10 will be added with 2, so it will be this 30, because this is decrementing 3, it becomes 2. So 2 is actually 30, and this is 2, this will be taken 32. Similarly, 10 plus 5 15 and 90 plus 4 94. Find and write the output of the following Python code. So this is a class item, and this is a constructor. In constructor 101, these are the default parameters, like I will be 101, and will be pen, and Q will be 10. First of all, this constructor is doing a task of assigning this I 101, and N as pen here, the name, and Q is 10. And then by, what is happening here, by? When you call this function, the quantity is increased by Q, that is this 10. Then sell, the quantity will be decreased by Q. And then the show stock will show the I number, the name and the quantity. So first of all, this constructor is called. So it will be assigned 101 and this pen and 10. Then we have item, we have called this I1, I2. I2 will be assigned 100, eraser and 100. So these value will be overridden. Again in I3, 102, sharpener, because the third value is not given, it will take 10. Please understand, I3 is going to take 10. I1 is going to take 10. And then I2 is going to take what value? This is 100. Okay. Now, first of all, when this, I'll show you the answer and then I'll explain you everything. First of all, you have to show i3.showStock. So where I3 is? I3 has been given 102 sharpener, and since there is no value, it will take 10. But after this, we have I3 by 75. We are buying with 75, and then we are showing the stock. But before that, I1 has buy 10, that is 110. It will become 110, and then sell 25 minus 25. So 110 minus 25 is what? 85, right? So 85 will be shown here. This will be the recent value. I hope you got the idea. 85 will be shown, and then I1 will show what? Because I1 will take value what? 10, and then we have I1 dot buy 10. So 10 will be added here. 10 plus 10 is 20. So 101, I1 is 101. This I1 will take 101, 10, and 10 it will take, but there is a I1 plus buy also. So I1 will take 20. Let us come to the third one, that is the I2. I2 is taking what value? 100. This is the 100. So 100 and eraser will be shown. This is okay. You got the idea when it is being show stock. But when we are dealing with the value, what it will be? There is I2 is 100. Then buy is there, or sell, this sell is there. So 100 minus 25. What will be there? 75. 75 will be shown for I2. What are the possible outcomes executed from the following code? Also specify the maximum and minimum value that can be assigned to value n. So it is a random. The maximum value which can be assigned is 1. The randint, the maximum value will be 1, 3, and minimum value will be 1. So 1 is minimum, 3 is maximum. So let us see here. This is the range n to 1. So if we give the highest value 3 to 1, and this is minus 1. So we are starting from the you can say rear. So this will come as 3 to 1. So south, north, west, it will show. So this is possible. Then if this is 2, so south, north can be shown. This will be shown. And next is 1. So only south will be shown. This. So all these are possible outcomes. This will not be an outcome. List 4 characteristics of object-oriented programming: encapsulation, data heading, abstraction, inheritance, and polymorphism. These are certain characteristics of object-oriented programming. This is a class test. Let us see what is being asked. First of all, in this class definition, both this function 1, this function, and this function, they have similar definition. That means this is a constructor, and this is a user-defined function assign. And both are doing the same job. They are assigning the value of R to roll number, M to marks. R to roll number and M to marks. They are doing the same stuff. How are they different in execution? The difference is, this is a constructor. So whenever an object is being made, you don't have to call this function. This will be automatically invoked. But for this assign, you have to specifically call this assign. Write statement to execute function 1 and function 2. So we'll see how function 1 and function 2 can be called. We'll just make an object of test that this will call. We'll make an object of test, and then we'll call this assign function. So let us see. See, the answer I gave was, function 1 is the constructor, this one, which gets executed automatically as soon as the object of the class is created. So how do we are going to call? Test 1,90. We are just making an object, and this object will be created, and 1 and 95 will be assigned to the roll number and member class variables of the object. Now, the second is second function calling. And since the function 2 is a member function which has to be called to assign the value to roll number and mark specifically, so we have to say e1.assign, then 1,90. Now assign will be called. So we have to make an object, then call this function specifically. Define a class ring in Python with following specification. So these are the specification. We'll directly jump into the class. This is class ring colon, or you can write class ring colon, or you can write class ring bracket object. So all these are okay. These are all fine. Then you will create a constructor, that is the init. So what it is going to give you, this is self.ring ID is equal to, say, some value 101, it is being given. This radius, self.radius, is equal to 10, and self.area is nothing, there is nothing, so we are giving zero value. We can also write like this, def init self. You can write ri, raa, and you can, for any variable instead of this, you can write. There is no boundation, it is up to you. But you have to assign this ring ID, ri, and ra to radius and a to area. This is how you have to do. Then we come to the function methods basically. Def area cal self, and this self area should be 3.14 into radius. So this is what we have here. The next is new ring. In this new ring, the method should ask for the input. So what we have done here is input enter ring ID, input enter radius, and then area cal self. So area cal is being calculated. So it is going to call the area cal. Then the view ring. This is to display. So we just have to print self ring ID, print self radius, and print self dot area. Differentiate between static and dynamic binding in Python, gives suitable example for each. Static binding means the function is linked with the function call at the compilation time. Dynamic binding means the function is linked to the function call or function definition. The function call will be linked to the function definition at the runtime. So the static binding, it allows linking of a function call to the function definition during the compilation of the program. While dynamic binding, it allows linking of a function at the runtime, not at the compile time. So this means that the code of the function that is to be linked with function call is unknown until it is actually run or executed. So dynamic binding of function makes the programs more flexible. Next is write two methods in Python using concept of function overloading, that is the polymorphism, and we should perform certain operation like this. So just read the question. I am going to show you the exact answer. It's quite easy. First is you have to have a function. We'll define it as area. Argument is side, so we give the argument as side, and we have to calculate the area of square as side into side. So just print side into side. The second is two arguments, length and breadth. So the name will be same. Length and breadth, these are the two arguments, and it will calculate the area of rectangle as length. So you just have to print length into breadth. Now what will be the status of the following list after the first, second and third pass of the bubble sort method used for arranging the following elements in descending order. So descending order means the highest should be here and the lowest should be here, in this way. Show the status of all the elements after each pass, very clearly underlining the changes. So in the first pass, which one is the lowest? -100. So this will take this place. In the second pass, let us assume -100 is here. And then in the second pass, which is the next one, 104. 104 is going to take this place. And then the third pass, which is the next one, that is the, say, 190. So 190 will take this place. This is how it should be. 150 is even lesser than 190. So what we will do here is, see, the final version is 10152104 -100. This is what we wanted. So we'll start with the first pass. In first pass, what will happen, we'll compare the two values, we'll compare the values, and we'll try to find out the values the two pairs or the nearby values, where, because it is the H to L, higher to lower. So we will check for the value, and if we'll check for two values, if this is lower than this, we have to swap. If this is higher than this, we will not swap. I hope you got the idea. So we'll start with this. First of all, we'll compare this these two. 152 is greater, no change. Then 104 to this -100, and we see that -104 is greater. Then we compare -100 with 604. This 104 is computed here. Now this is -104. This is the first, second and third. -100 to 604. Now we see that this is lesser than this. So we need to swap these two. So -100 comes here, 604 comes here. Next we'll compare this -100 with 190. Again -100 and -100 is lesser than 190. So we need to swap them. So 190 will come here, minus this will come here, this will come here. then minus 100 will be compared with 204, and again we see minus 100 is less than 204. So 204 will come here, 100 will come, minus 100 will come here, because we want the lowest to come here. That is why we are swapping, otherwise we will not swap. Next is, again we are going to do the same thing, but we are going to leave this line. Will not see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are six in first pass. There are six iterations, you can say. Here we'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 iterations only, because we are not will not be including this column now or this number. Now let us start again. 1552 to 104, no problem. 104 to 604, yes problem, because 104 is lesser. So 604 will come here, 104 will come here. Now 104 with 190 will come here, 104 will come here. Then 104 204 20 will come here, 104 will come here. This 104 is the next lowest of these elements. Now this is done, we'll leave these two. Now there will be only four iterations. Again we'll do the same stuff. 152 to 604, yes, there is a problem, because not problem, but we need to swap them. 604 will come here, 152 will come here. 152 190 in 190, 152 is lower, it will go there, this 190 will come here. Then 152 204, again 204 will come here, 152 will come here. Then we'll compare 152 with 104, there is no problem, so 152 is in the correct position. So this is the third pass. We have been asked for second and third pass. Write definition of member odd number functions to add those values in the list numbers which are odd. So the checking of odd is simply modulo 2. If you check some x with modulo 2 and it is equal to 0, then it is, that is, the remainder is 0, that means it is an even number. And if it is not, if you use a not operator, we say it is not a even number, that is an odd number. So similarly, same logic will apply here. We'll make a function def odd sum numbers. These numbers, we have to find out the length. So the length will be found out by len n. We'll start with sum equal to 0. So we have to find out the sum of the value. So we'll take s, or you can take sum equal to 0 like this. From I in range n, for I in range n, you'll take all the value and take the modulo with 2, and you say not equal to 0. That is, they have to be odd. If they are odd, then you add the numbers. S is equal to s plus number I. This number I. And then you print. Write add new and remove method to, in Python, to add a new book and remove a book from the list of books, considering them as act of push and pop operation of the data structure stack. So let us see this stack. We have to write an add new and remove. So what we'll do here is, we'll make a book, that is a list, you can say, then add new self. You just have to ask user, enter the book name, you will transfer it to name. Then here, this is very important line. These two are very important lines. See, this one and this one. So stack dot book dot append, then name is appended. Then in the remove, if we'll check for the emptiness. If the stack is empty, we cannot remove. Stack, we will say stack is empty. Then if the stack is not empty, then we will delete the book. That is stack dot book dot pop. Pop is taking out, that is equivalent to removing. And adding is nothing but appending. Write definition of method a find to display all the city names from a list of cities which are starting with alphabet A. So all these should come. A, Amritsar, this Ahmedabad, Amritsar and Agra should come. So the logic is very easy. You have to just check the zeroth value of the say array or the list. The first element of the list. And if it is equal to 0, if it is equal to A, I'm so sorry. If it is equal to A, then you have to just print it. So the code is very easy. Def A find cities. For I in these cities, if I 0, if the first element of the city is A, you say print I. So these will be printed. Evaluate the following postfix notation of the expression. So how we are going to do this? When 2 will come, we'll place it in the 2. 3 will come, place it in the 3. Then into will come, we'll pop 2 into 3, 2 and 3. We'll multiply them, means this operator is applied on this. The result is 6, we'll place it in the stack. Then again 4 has come, so we'll this after this 24 has come. So 24 will be placed on the stack along with 6. Then the next is 24, after that we have 2. So 2 will be placed, then 6 will be placed. Then plus has come. So we'll take these two out. 2 plus 6 will do. And again place it back to the stack. After this, division has come. So we'll take these two out. 24 and 8. Divide them. 3 will come. 3 will be placed again in this stack. Then we have minus. So we'll take these two out. We'll divide these 6 by 3. And the result will be placed on the stack. This is your final result. That is, the answer is 3. Differentiate between files mode R plus and W plus with respect to Python. So R plus opens the file for both reading and writing, but the file pointer is placed at the beginning of the file. W plus is opening the file for reading and writing, and it overrides the existing file if the file is existing. And if the file does not exist, it will create a new file again for reading and writing. Next is write a method in Python to read lines from a text file, this one, and display those lines which are starting with the alphabet P. Again, we have to open this text file, and we have to see the first, we'll just read line and check for the first character to be P, and we'll print them, otherwise we'll not print. So we'll write a function def display. This is file is equal to open diary.txt in read mode. Then we'll do read line file dot read line, each line, while line means each line. If line 0, the first value is P, we'll print the line, otherwise we'll not print. And this file dot read line is placed in line, and we close the file. Considering the following definition of class company, write a method in Python to search and display the content in pickle file company dot dot. So the company dot dat is actually a binary file where this comp ID is matching with the value 1005. So wherever it is matching, then we have to give a result. So this is a class which is company, and this is the constructor which is giving this CID to comp ID, a name to this CName, and turnover is 1000. Then we have to display these three. So what we do here is import pickle. You can write any name of the function because this is question 4C. So we have written quest 4C. Then f equal to factory, then file open this one with read binary, and then we have to write in the try except block, and then while true we'll load from the file pickle.load, and if this f.comp id is 1004 we display, otherwise we'll do some end of file error pass, then we close the file. So these are the questions on Python specifically. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.